So, I'm going to be working on this new diamond paint I just unwrapped. I first take the plastic off. But you want to keep the plastic for if you take breaks in between. I'm going to start with the first color here, which is number one. It is the, looks like these kind of like equal signs on here. I'm going to get some of those out. I never dump all of them out just because you might have to. Well, you might spill them everywhere, so you would like to save them. I always change out my wax to begin with. Because if you don't change your wax to begin with, you're going to be fighting with it the whole time. The wax lets you pick up the little beads. So, I'm going to put on the outside. Some on the side. And I'm going to straighten them out. And just start plopping them away here. So. This area doesn't need as many. I don't know, I like starting with the side that has the least amount. And because I keep leaning over and sticking my hand to the side, what I'm going to do is I'm going to get some parchment paper. I'm going to cover up this section so I don't have the glue dry out on me. So everywhere where that equal sign is not, it's going to be covered. Yes, like that. Just helps me not stick to it and the glue not to dry out. So you don't want the glue to dry out. You can see I'm overlapping the pieces because it helps me pull them off later. I got most of it covered up, so when I lean on it, my hand ain't gonna stick to it. I'm gonna continue doing my first color here, which is the equal sign. There's a little green. Started on his ear. Oops. I like to make sure I got enough here. I had the fuzz stuck in it. I love hearing that snapping noise. Somehow I already have cat fuzz in this. Mostly floating in the air. Sure, some of you got cats and dogs, probably get the fuzz stuck in it too. Probably all the time. That's why even if you use all this parchment paper to cover it, you still want to use the plastic sheet to keep over top of it. So you can keep that cat fuzz and dog fuzz out. It is around his eye here. bit on that crook. I'm a little crooked. Can we fix those? I got. You always fix these after you put them in. And I'm never too worried about being crooked because I have a little straightener that I use at the end, which looks like this. And you can just go in between and you can straighten them all up. And also, as you place beads, more and more of these beads on there, they start looking more straight. Because they bump into each other and there's not much space between them normally. So, if at the beginning, you know, it looks a little wonky, it'll get better. Hi, Dibs. My kitty cat's visiting. He's sniffing around trying to figure out what I'm doing here. Hi, Dibs. Are you coming to say hi? I'm just sniffing around. I like to do the outlines for some reason first, and then I fill in the middle. So if you see me jumping all over this, that's pretty much what I'm trying to do. Really, no particular order, you know, you have to do them, you just do them by the colors. I'm going to go back with my straightener on some of these. I can tell they're crooked. I try not to like focus on them at the beginning because I know it's going to be that way, and if I did that, it would never get done. I wonder if I can straighten this a little bit. That way I'm not working on such a like a wrinkle there. Getting up his stick. The side's popping off. That's much better. So much easier to work with now. Now I just got the middle sections to do here, just filling in the gaps. So when you get to this part, you know, I make like a checker pattern to make sure it stays straight. It helps. And you can see it slides the other ones around. And it helps straighten that line out. Oh, that's sometimes why I skip every other one. I love hearing that click noise. Just makes me feel like, oh, I'm doing something, you know, correct. And I got one more here. And it's all of that color. Let me see. Starting to see his face.